Hi, everyone. Welcome to this episode of Sip and Sync with Azure. In this one, we're talking about Azure Extensions in GitHub Copilot. I am very excited to have a special guest, Krystal, on the show. Welcome to the show, Krystal.
Hey, Priyanka. Thank you for having me on the show for today. I'm excited to share a little bit about GitHub Copilot and what GitHub can actually do.
Awesome. So Krystal is from our developer productivity team, which is why I think we're going to get a ton of amazing information today. With that, before we dive into Azure Extensions, why don't we talk a little bit, just give us a little bit of an intro of GitHub Copilot, what it does, what it's great for.
Yeah, so GitHub Copilot is really pretty basically your peer programmer, where you're able to work with Copilot to actually help you productive through your IDE, as well as the GitHub for Enterprise for Cloud. Copilot is really there to help you with planning, production, code reviewing, integrations, and really help you improve your software development lifecycle. And so this is where the tool is going to be able to assist you in enabling you to work faster.
Awesome. So software development lifecycle and all the things that are part of that lifecycle, including creating code, deploying, testing, all of that, improving that, then being productive using AI is kind of what GitHub Copilot does, right? Software development lifecycle on steroids, maybe? That's how I like to describe it.
Yeah.
And so when we talk about Azure extensions, mm-hmm. and there are lots of extensions with GitHub Copilot, today we're talking specifically about Azure extensions. Tell us a little bit about where to begin, how to get started, and what it helps us do.
Yeah. So let me jump right into the IDE. And so with the extensions here, you'll first install the extension for GitHub Copilot for Azure. So it will look like this. So you'll look for the GitHub Copilot for Azure extension and make sure that you're logged into GitHub Copilot. Once you have that set up, make sure that you set up your tenant as well. The Azure extension will happen in the chat. So it's a part of the chat, Copilot chat capability. You'll just do at Azure once it's installed. And then you could see some of the commands that we'll have here for getting started. So they have where you can change your Azure subscription, manage the costs, diagnose, explain some things about the platform, as well as learn additional information about your resources as well.
Okay, so maybe we'll go see some of this in action, but why don't we start off with Azure, what are the different services maybe available to us, and that can help us get going with how the extension is actually very powerful to not have me go outside of the platform, look for what's available, and then come back and start coding.
Yeah, so let me show you a little bit about how we can use that extension today. So the first thing I'll do is a little bit learn about what AI models are available. So with that, let's see what real-time OpenAI models is available on the platform. And so I can learn a little bit about what's happening in our Azure AI Foundry and really use that as a way to keep up to date with what I can be available within my subscription. So that's one way to look at that and see, as you can see here, the models are, you know, showing me exactly which one are real-time models that I can actually use within my applications.
Yep, and it also shows you some of the other things that you can do, which is what the service overview, if I wanted to get into that, which is great because it's kind of reading my mind at this point.
Yeah. So it's kind of like collaborating. It's like that person that has that next step, like natural next step, which is really great because sometimes you don't even think about the things that you really need. And you're like, hey, Copilot is already kind of prompting me to think about things that I think is natural next step.
Great. So with that, let's say I now want to deploy my application mm-hmm. and I'm picking between different services. What type of compute do I want to use? Maybe show us an example of something like that.
Yeah, so a good example with that would be is I'm going to ask the difference between deploying that application or AI model to Azure Container Apps or Azure Kubernetes Service, and what are the pros and cons. And so what is this doing is really kind of helping me as a developer understand the differences between our services on the platform. Mm-hmm. So differences between putting it on platform as a service or infrastructure as a service, where knowing like the differences where that, you know, the strategy behind that is kind of having that like a cloud solution architect with you to help you decide and actually has the knowledge of, you know, what's the best on the platform and how to deploy that best to the platform.
Great. I see kind of going into pros and cons and stuff, which is perfect. Now, let's say I am at a point where I need to debug an application. How can Azure Extensions help me do that?
Yeah, so if you have applications where you need debugging, you can actually ask specific ask about errors on the platform. So you can actually troubleshoot specific errors, and you can also, and it will pull the errors directly from the Azure Monitoring API. And so if you have Azure Monitoring enabled, you're able to see that as well. In this example, I'm going to show exactly how specific errors to this application is using this real-time API. And then I can see that these are all the different types of errors that I can get. And so as a developer, this may give me insights on exactly how to troubleshoot and as well as make test cases and edge cases within my code to make sure that it's up for production.
Great. There's lots of stuff that we need to worry about when we are automating in our infrastructure, right?
Yeah.
So I'd love to see how you would do that with, let's say, Terraform script that we need for infrastructure as code and automation.
Yeah, so in this example, I'll show a little bit about how I use the same API that I'm using in the application and how would I simulate permissions with Playwright script. So with that, I would say, I want to make a Playwright script, which is a platform that we also have on Azure, where you're able to actually enable the UI automation for testing your applications. As this is a web app that is using this open endpoint, I want to be able to say, hey, I need to do this, and I also want to deploy that. If, you know, for enterprise customers, a lot of them do use Terraform as their service to be able to deploy that. So with that, they say we want to deploy that in within the region that I want to have for my application. I could deploy that using Terraform and be specific, right? You could use Azure Bicep or Azure ARM, or you could use Azure CLI. So you can be specific with the Copilot, and it knows how to create that for that specific infrastructure as code.
And I see that it generated that, which is great. Now, if I wanted to, all this is great, and a lot of teams are going to be like, I need to first understand how much this is going to cost me, right?
Mm-hmm.
And I saw that you had that slash cost up there initially.
Yeah.
So let's see a little bit of the demo for understanding cost.
Yeah. So one thing I think is important to understand as you're developing is how does the cost actually impact, you know, the application, what you're going to do, how do you want to do and leverage resources on the platform? So being able to actually look at the resources and how much they cost within your resource group directly from the IDE, especially as you're deploying, developing stuff, is really awesome. So you can kind of take that into consideration when you're deploying, as well as what's costing per token per model as you're doing that test as well.
And I see that you've got a table there.
Yeah, so it outputs with a table where you can see the different services within that resource group. You can call it by specific resource, or you can actually just specifically ask for a specific resource group like I did, or you can say within the subscription. So you can get very, very broad or very narrow on the specifics on that, or you can call out how much is this one app is costing me.
So what's really, really insightful in the entire set of prompts that you showed and that I grasped immediately is the fact that you're able to have context of your environment and what's happening in your application and your app and even the cost is specific to what you are building, which is extremely useful because it's not generic information coming from just our documentation. It is specific to your application. What else is the benefit of using Azure Extensions?
Yeah, I think the main benefit that most, there's two types of benefits here, but I think the main two benefits is the first is for new people who are new to the platform. So as you have new developers who have never deployed on Azure before, this is a great tool to get them up to speed. They can ask questions, they can discover. So this is really great for like junior developers who are new to cloud platform engineering. And as well as like for the senior developers, they're able to produce and with a quality code without having to break that focus. I think the big part about Copilot is trying to keep developers in the IDE and keep them happy. And so a little bit of that is bringing that Azure extension right into the platform where they don't have to go to the browser and actually have to like figure it out.
Yeah.
So I love that about it. And I think that's the biggest two key points is keep developers right into the IDE where they want to be focused.
Exactly. No context switching. That's perfect. Thank you so much, Krystal, for this amazing demo. And thank you all for joining us today. I hope you found Azure Extensions to be something you want to try. And if you do give it a try, let us know in the comments below what you think. Give us feedback and let us know what you'd like to see in future episodes. With that, we'll see you next time.
Thank you.